The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network. I'm not afraid, to take a stand.
Live off the record with Zhivargo Laing is sponsored by the Cleveland Clinic, Fidelity Bank Bahamas, the Jeff Rogers Basketball Camp, RF Bank and Trust, Raw Star Assurance, and the Water and Sewage Corporation.
Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Wednesday afternoon. So glad that you could. If you want to give us a call at any point today, the numbers to do so would be 323-6232, 323-6232, or 325-4316, 325-4316. Or you can text us on 422-4796. That's 422-4796, or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. That's 439-3043. So let me give you the lay of the land today. I have some very special guests I want to talk to about a very special event that's upcoming. And then after that, we're going to talk about Adrian Gibson and this issue of calling for his resignation. I have had the honor of interacting with the late Dr. Miles Monroe and his wife, Ruth Monroe, and I've had and enjoyed some beautiful times with them. I recall an occasion on which we were in San Diego, California, and we were browsing through one of the department stores, and Sister Ruth decided, because my daughter at the time might have been about 6 years old, and she had taken her on her little adopted daughter. And she decided there was some beautiful dresses that she was going to purchase for her, and which she did, and said, "Yeah, please give this to my daughter," she would say. And just number of beautiful occasions like that, either around a kitchen counter or outside on the porch, etc. And so my guests here to talk about a very special event involving the annual event involving Sister Ruth Monroe. And so I'm so happy to have Madam Kim, welcome, and Sonia Brown with us today. Welcome, ladies. You have to unmute.
Thank you, Zhivargo. Really excited to be joining you. Hi, Zhivargo, can you hear me?
Kim, if you're trying, yes. Okay, yes, go ahead, ladies.
Thank you so much for really excited to be joining you today.
Yes, thank you, Zhivargo. Good to be able to talk to you about this.
Thank you. Thank you for having us participate in getting the message out. So tell us what's going on.
Well, on June 25th, which is this week's Saturday, we are hosting the very first annual Ruth Monroe Family Food Fun Fest at BFM on Carmichael Road. And this is really a way of celebrating her life and her contributions. You know, she was definitely a woman of about family. She was about women. And this is actually being powered by our Women of Excellence Ministry at Bahamas Faith Ministries. And it's funny you tell this story about her just wanting to buy your daughter some dresses. And I have, as we've been planning this event, I've heard so many stories of just her little personal things that she's done for people just out of the kindness of her heart, because that's who she was.
And indeed, such a calm soul, pleasant soul from all the interactions I've ever had, just always so deliberate and intentional. Her and Pascal were just like hand in glove tandem. I don't know where we get that noise from, but one of your mics, your mic, I think, is you're having some issues. Yeah. So the event is on Saturday coming.
Yes, it starts at 11 a.m. It's on the grounds of Bahamas Faith Ministries. And we just have a lot of things that will be going on during that day. So there will be a special fashion show. You know, Pastor Ruth was very meticulous about the way she presented herself. She was always dressed to the nine, such a lady. And so we're having a fashion show. There's going to be a slam dunk 3-point competition for the guys.
I ain't gonna lie, you got me there. You got me on the slam dunk competition, though. You really, I'm like, I went down the list and I go, nah, man, seriously, dogs, a slam dunk competition? Wow.
Shivago, come win some money, man. Come win some money.
Yeah, you see, we're tempting me. You know, this whole me and my little bus up now. But if I was a little younger, boy, oh.
And if I was a little bit taller, I'd be a baller.
Sonia, yeah. Sonia, are you there with us?
Yeah, I'm here.
Good. So, slam dunk competition. You have the Charlie, the Yellow Bahamian. You have the Boston Castle painting. You know, of course, you got Bahamian food. So, hey.
Yeah, and we're ending the evening with a gospel concert, and that's going to be really, really good. This is all being coordinated by DJ. People know him. And, you know, the proceeds are going towards Women of Excellence and the initiatives that they put on to help women. A lot of women just in the community, even, they come to BFM for help for different things. And we want to be able to have the resources to assist them. And so that's why we're doing this fundraiser. And then part proceeds also go to Youth Alive. And I think everybody has heard of the amazing work that Youth Alive does every single year with young people.
Yeah, I remember in 1989, 90, etc. That's when I first went to Youth Alive through Pastor Dave Burroughs, then the Roughneck pastor. And I was one of the annual speakers at Youth Alive.
Shivali, you're going to give away your age. Be careful.
No, mine, I'm scared, man. I can be 55 come September. So I'm getting up there for sure.
Absolutely.
So folks can just come out at the events and participate in what is a beautiful memorial to a beautiful human being.
Absolutely. And there is something for everybody in the family. You know, like you mentioned, we got the things going on for the kids as well as adults.
Okay.
All right. I'm really excited about the bands, too. We have a couple of bands as well. So that's going to be special treat for the young people, because the bands are young people.
These are marching bands?
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow. Okay, cool. I love a marching band. Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, we have the All-Star Marching Band, which is known throughout the community for being fantastic. So we're excited about having them.
We have that drummer.
Yes, their drumline. Yeah.
And you know what I love about this is because it's a family food fun fest. And it is indicative of something that Sister Ruth was so into, which was family. And so here you have an opportunity for mommy, daddy, children, uncle, aunts, everybody to get involved, no matter the character of your family, and to be able to enjoy together and separate events on that beautiful, huge grounds there at BFM.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely. And there's going to be food galore, all kinds of choices, you know, including roadie and some of our fantastic local vendors who do specialty food items. So, you know, come on out and eat.
See, first of all, I think this is where you all went wrong when you came on the show, because you didn't start off telling people what the food choices would be. Because I will be refuse to believe in June, Father's Day, ain't gonna be no crab and rice out there. Maybe some crab and grits out there. Some kung fritters and stuff like that out there. So am I lying or what?
There will certainly be kung fritters. We got, you know, like I said, some specialty food vendors. I don't know if you're familiar with Batter Girls, but they do a Cajun shrimp with wedges. And we got a young lady doing some authentic roadie straight from Guyana. Yes, the Women of Excellence will be doing ribs and chicken and those things that you always know.
Things that you just mentioned, some of those things.
Yes, absolutely. So there's going to be a lot of food choices, lots of food choices, and stuff for kids, you know, like pizza and things that they love to eat. So my plan is to eat there and then take dinner home as well.
there's another plan, see, because what you're saying is you can save yourself a meal on Sunday because you can carry Sunday from there.
Yes, well, the Saturday night meal as well as the Sunday meal. I will be purchasing.
Anybody's eat Saturday night, man. You just fool around on Saturday night eating junk or something like that.
My junk gonna be my roadie. Honey, I already have it planned.
All right. Well, once again, Saturday coming. So this is Saturday coming. BFM there on Carmichael Road starts at 11 a.m. and ends at?
Ends at 7 p.m. And I would like to just thank a few of our sponsors, because we've had so many people from the community join in to help us to pull this off, including Zaymar Group of Companies, Specialized Dentistry, Purity Bakery, Little Caesars donated pizzas to us, Trade Facilitators, Custom Brokers, as well as some agents from Nassau Family Guardian Financial Center. That would be Ingrid Cambridge and Kenya Saunders, and John Larimore at Mac Consultants, as well as Macari, and that is a beauty loft. So we appreciate those who have jumped in to sponsor us, and we just want to say thank you, as well as Belle Femme, and they're in the kiosk at the Marathon Mall.
Also, the Catwalk Boutique, who is partnering with us on the fashion show.
Yes, that's right. They'll be doing our fashion show, which will be fantastic. So it's exciting, and we are excited about the community involvement. And there's going to be free blood pressure screening, so people can come on out and have your blood pressure taken and get that for free. So we're just trying to do something for the community within the community.
And something beautiful for a beautiful person, a wonderful person, the late Ruth Monroe. What a wonderful human being. And thank you, ladies. I hope and trust that things go exceptionally well on.
Thank you so much, Zhivargo. Thank you so much for having us.
All right. Great. Thanks a lot. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We're so glad you could join us. When we come back, we're going to talk some Agent Gibson on resignation talk. We'll be back after this break.
Take a step. Everybody, everybody. Switch for better when you move your mortgage to Scotiabank.
Leave behind that old mortgage plan and open the door to a low interest rate. No payments for up to 2 months and cash back of 2.5% of the mortgage amount up to $10,000. And guess what? It gets better. Apply for your Scotiabank credit card at a low 9.99% introductory rate for the first 6 months. Switch for better and upgrade your mortgage today with Scotiabank. Offer ends June 30th, 2022.
Around the world, Cleveland Clinic is recognized as a leader in healthcare. Our team of experts relentlessly pursues the best for our patients. From groundbreaking cancer research to state-of-the-art heart surgery, life-saving innovations happen here every day. When it's time to travel for your health, it's time to travel to Cleveland Clinic, your destination for care, for every care in the world. To learn more, visit clevelandclinic.org/Caribbean.
I used to think of the bank as my personal ATM machine. If I wanted a new car, new furniture, a weekend trip to Miami, no problem, just max out the credit card or top up my loan. I was a big baller until I realized that 75% of my salary was going to pay back all those loans. Fidelity's personal financial coaching was the best solution. Fidelity gave me a plan with a debt consolidation loan that has a built-in savings that pays 5% interest. I now only have one low monthly payment, plus money in my pocket. Give Fidelity Bank a call at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit any of Fidelity's locations or visit a website at fidelitygroup.com. Fidelity, we're good for
you. I'm not afraid, to take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm, let me know that you're not alone. I'll up if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm your host. So glad you could join us today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Wednesday afternoon. If you want to give us a call at all today on the show, the numbers are 323-6232, 323-6232, or 325-4316, 325-4316. You can text us on 422-4796. Or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. So I'm breathing, doing my breathing exercises so that I can dispassionately and calmly go through this issue. Loretta Butler Turner is reported in The Guardian, a story written by Dia Deans, fantastic senior journalist of the country. She's reported to have said that Mr. Michael Pintard, in not asking MP Adrian Gibson to resign his seat in Parliament so that Mr. Gibson could focus on his legal troubles and divert a needed distraction away from the party, reflects poorly on Pintard's leadership. That's the first thing. She goes on to say, and I quote, "I believe that the leader has got to support his member in every which way that the party can. But I do not believe that he should support him in the position of remaining an MP while he's dealing with this legal battle." End quote. She says, and quote again, you know, quite frankly, they do need to support him. He's one of theirs. He's family, as they say. You don't know where they're going to have to assist. But at the end of the day, the party leader needs to make a determination that is that this is not just a reflection right now on Mr. Gibson. This is a reflection on the type of leadership that he will have if he ever takes the reins of. So she says, if he were the leader of the country and he took this position, this would not be looked upon well. He is the leader in waiting. He cannot change principles based on where he's at. He wants to lead this country, so he's got to demonstrate astute leadership at this point. There's the critical point, astute leadership. So let me tell you, at some point, there is going to come something called a bill of indictment. And that bill of indictment is going to outline specifically and clear what the charges are, what the evidence is, against Mr. Adrian Gibson. Now, an astute leader of a political party would not call for the resignation of someone without first eyeballing what the evidence is against them, at the very least. At the very least, but not do so. Okay? And this is a view shared by not just Zhivargo, Laing, but some very astute leaders in the country, political leaders in the country, seasoned and experienced leaders in the country. No bill of indictment yet. Referencing the evidence against. A set of charges is a set of charges against you. What's the evidence? I don't know. And I don't know what the evidence is. I don't know if he's trumped up. I don't know if it was. So I don't know. I don't know what the evidence is to see how strong the case is. But yet I'm going to come and call for you to resign because it's a distraction. Because it's not going to be a distraction when you are in court day in and day out. Even as the former member of parliament for Long Island, there's not gonna be a distraction to the party that you are an FNM member who just recently resigned from having charges against you, laid against you for things you did under an FNM administration. That's not gonna be distracting because people are gonna forget that. Seriously? Not only that, it's not going to be distracting because when I ask you to resign, it is going to immediately prompt a by-election in that constituency, in which for some weeks to come, you are going to have to, Mr. Leader of the FNM, run a campaign in Long Island where your member of parliament just resigned to tell people to vote for a new person for you, in a campaign which the governing party under whose charge you are being, your former member who just resigned is being prosecuted. I didn't say persecuted, I said prosecuted. Saying the reason why this by-election is being held is because your member of parliament, FNM member of parliament had to resign because he had charges of corruption levied against him, and that's not going to be distracting at all to the leadership of the party. That's not going to be distracting. Seriously? All of this before a bill of indictment comes. An astute leader, I submit to you, would not do that. Wouldn't do it. Okay. Secondly, once the bill of indictment comes, a judgment will have to be made, assessment will have to be made by the leadership of the Free National Movement, in which, based on the evidence that they see, they make a determination about probabilities of conviction. And at such a time, not publicly, because you talk about helping your family, helping your member, not being injurious to your member. At which time you are going to have and can have quiet discussions with them about what is prudent in the circumstances. Because surely it will look better if the member decides, you know what, given all of this, I have to go ahead and dedicate myself to this, and it could be abundantly challenging otherwise, and so I'm going to resign. You don't have to prejudice the situation by having both his resignation called for and a resignation, or a resistance to the call for a resignation, which invites now both the court case and this unification between you and him. An astute leader would not put himself in that position. Would not do so. Because it's not helpful. In any event, it is not helpful to the party, it's not helpful to the member, it's not helpful to the country to have that additional set of circumstances prevail. And so I think Loretta Butler-Turner has some good points made about the party wanting to support an X, Y, and Z, but I think this notion that calling for that resignation now is a testament of Mr. Pintard's leadership, I think that's off. And it's off because the timing of such a call now and in this manner would not be astute at all. It would not be astute. It would not be beneficial. In fact, who benefits from Mr. Gibson's resignation right now? I mean, if he's going to be astute as a political leader, he has to be astute to the end that a political party exists to win the government, and you win the government by popular support. Who wins? Who benefits if he resigns right now? Every person interested in the Long Island seat wins. Is a main benefit. Every person interested to run in the Long Island seat benefits if Mrs. Gibson resigns right now. Every person. And unless you declare that you are not interested in the Long Island seat, then you are one potential such person. That's who benefits. If he resigns, is the political party to which he belongs, is that party better off and more probable about winning that seat than otherwise? No. They got the seat now. They have the vote now. Not that it can make much difference in the face of the votes from PLV, but they got the votes and they have the seat now. When you have a by-election, you ain't guaranteed to have that seat, especially since you then lose the government. You have a member of parliament who is embroiled in controversy. And now you're going back to those same people in Long Island to ask them to trust you again, the condition where the governing power is in the hands of your opponents, not yourself anymore. I don't see the wisdom of calling for Mr. Pintard to call for that resignation today. There's no wisdom in that. And I'm not alone in that assessment. And there are certainly some brighter, more brilliant minds than mine who are not of that view. I do think that bill of indictment will trigger a set of events that might change the circumstances of a resignation. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid to take a stand. Take a stand.
The Water and Sewage Corporation advises residents of Pinecrest Drive, South Beach East, that the corporation will commence improvement work on Tuesday, May 31st, 2022, for a duration of 5 weeks, from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. daily. During this period, there may be some interruption in the water supply, road closure, and detours around the work area. Motorists are advised to avoid the area where possible. The corporation apologizes for any inconvenience caused and appreciates your support as they work to improve their level of service.
Imagine driving your dream car, doing all the things you never thought you could, like perfecting your parallel parking skills or picking up your date. Everyone loves to dream. Stop dreaming. Start driving with a brand new offer from Scotiabank. With an auto loan from Scotiabank, benefit from no payments for up to 2 months, a low interest rate up to 9 years to repay, and free insurance for the first year up to 2.5% of the loan amount. Promotion ends June 30th, 2022. Stop dreaming and start driving today with an auto loan from Scotiabank.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today. Workout, breakfast, drop kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails for 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Wednesday afternoon. I'm so glad you could join us today. If you want to give us a call, the numbers are 323-6232. That's 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4316. You can text us on 422-4796. Or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. To be sure, I don't pretend to be a legal expert on any of these matters. I try to take guidance and advice wherever I get it. And I'm happy to get guidance otherwise. We're talking about the calls for Adrian Gibson's resignation. And I, in particular, was talking about some comments made by Loretta Butler-Turner in respect of the astuteness of Mr. Pintard's leadership in not calling for him to resign. I just cannot see how that is wisdom. And so therefore, do not agree with that call. Even if a time comes when such a call might be made, I don't believe it will be made publicly. I don't believe it would be in their interest to make it publicly. In most instances, I've known prime ministers and leaders to have a talk with people and invite them to do so, as opposed to publicly calling for or firing such people. Try to do so as not to disadvantage them in any way. It is, in fact, the honorable way to deal with those matters in many instances, right? Secondly, let me say something to you. The members of the House of Assembly are never referred to, are not honorable member, right? By that I mean their title is not the honorable so-and-so who is sitting in the House of Assembly saving, and except that person is a cabinet minister. The House of Assembly is honorable. So we talk about the honorable House of Assembly. Now, it is not uncommon in the House of Assembly for members to be referred to as honorable, but that is an ascription to them based on their association with the Honorable House of Assembly. But outside of that house, no one applies the title honorable to them. That is applied to a cabinet minister. Okay? Now, we've seen cabinet ministers resign in the Bahamas for ethical breaches. Some may say legal breaches that didn't come into legal proceedings. But we've seen them, this was for conflicts of interest or for interfering with the judiciary or these kinds of things. Now, such persons resign their cabinet post where they were referred to as honorable, but keep their House of Assembly seat. Keep their House of Assembly seat. An action on your part that brought you into disrepute at the level of cabinet did not impact upon your having the seat you hold as dishonorable. How is that possible? It is possible because you get appointed as a cabinet minister by a prime minister and you serve at his pleasure. So he can appoint and unappoint you. He who appoints can disappoint. You get elected to the House of Assembly by the people in your constituency. And the Constitution constructed itself in such a way as to make it very difficult outside of those people for you to be removed from office, from that seat. So difficult that you could be convicted of a crime, serve a jail sentence for less than 12 months and still not disqualify yourself for the seat. But you've been convicted. Convicted. Honorable in the circumstances. Convicted. Jail. Why would a constitution allow such a thing? See, let me tell you something. However improbable a thing may be, it is improbable Prime Minister Davis, Prime Minister Minnis, Prime Minister Ingram, Prime Minister Christie, Prime Minister Pinley would conspire with the Attorney General, the Commissioner of Police, and others to do a thing. That is highly improbable, but it ain't impossible. And so treacherous a thing is this improbable thing that the Constitution constructed itself in a way to make sure that if such an improbable thing happened, it couldn't result automatically in the removal of a person duly elected by the people so as to frustrate the very democracy that the Constitution is designed to construct and to protect. Now, this is separate and apart from a choice that someone who is a member of the House of Assembly has to make about what they should do in the face of charges levied against them. That's separate and apart from that personal choice, which is important for them and for their constituents, is separate and apart from the foundations and fundamentals and institutional parameters established to protect the sanctity of the vote, because the vote is more sanctimonious than the parliament. Without the vote, there is no parliament. The vote is the most important thing. You protect that. What did the man say? Give me the ballot or the bullet? The vote. That's where the democracy has its expression, in the vote. How do you get at a democracy without the vote? Means people rule. How do you know the people rule? Same and except they can give a vote. Absence of a vote is the presence of a dictatorship. Absence of the vote is the presence of authoritarianism. Absence of the vote. And if the vote cannot be respected above all, then your democracy already is at risk. And so, yes, because of the sanctity of the vote, the member of parliament, under any set of circumstances, may and should, as should the leader of the political party for whom that member is a member, should go to the voters, have words with the voters, and get guidance from the voters on such a thing as their vote. A member of parliament trying to determine whether or not my charges are bringing dishonor to my representation should go ask the people who vote for him. Hey, bro, sisters, brothers, am I capable of serving you? In the circumstances, it doesn't matter whether I'm guilty or innocent. If I'm innocent, but I'm a disservice to you, please, you let me know. Let me know. If enough of them say so, and the man don't go, or the woman don't go, there's something wrong with them. Because I would happily say in the face of charges, that I spoke to my constituents, they told me that this is too distracting for us. We think you ought to go. And I've gauged enough of them to know, in the circumstances, I do not want to frustrate their will. And I will resign under the circumstances. I would do that. That's how you preserve the democracy. You don't preserve the democracy because people charge you, allegate things against you, and then you decide. Because I don't like the look of it, I'm gone. You live in a world like that. You live in a world like that. That'd be a difficult world to live in, especially when you're in politics. Trust me on that. Simple matters. These are not easy matters. These are not uncomplicated matters. And these are not matters on which somebody has a perspective that you should illegitimize their perspective, because there's certainly credibility, legitimacy, foundations in their perspectives on the matter, just as there might be in mine. And mine might not, you know, cannot claim to have an exclusive rightness in the circumstances, nor theirs. And so I dare not say that about anyone who has a different point of view or perspective than the one I share today. I just share a perspective. And that's why I wouldn't go to war on this one. I ain't losing no friends on this one. I ain't losing no family on this one, because I'm giving a perspective. Right? Where the truth is, that's what I die for. I die for the truth, not my perspective, not my opinion. There was a time in my life when I almost felt like I would die for my opinion, but I ain't doing that no more. No, man, when I was a child, I speak as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as I became a man, I put away childish things, and it is childish to die for an opinion. You die for the truth. You lose friends for the truth. You lose family for the truth. You don't do it for any other reason. And even for the truth, you don't lose people if you could save it. You right? You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break, the news break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm, let me know that you're not alone.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Sheila, you okay? I see smoke coming from your window.
Chad, Johnny Moe's burning down the house frying chicken.
Your kitchen is a mess. You have insurance?
If I have insurance, I pulled my phone out, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and in no time, I was on live chat with RSA rep, sent pics of the damage, filed my claim on the spot.
Wow, I don't think my insurance got that kind of...
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
I used to think of the bank as my personal ATM machine. If I wanted a new car, new furniture, a weekend trip to Miami, no problem. Just max out the credit card or top up my loan. I was a big baller until I realized that 75% of my salary was going to pay back all those loans. Fidelity's personal financial coaching was the best solution. Fidelity gave me a plan with a debt consolidation loan that has a built-in savings that pays 5% interest. I now only have one low monthly payment, plus money in my pocket. Give Fidelity Bank a call at 356-7764 in Nassau or 352-6676 in Freeport. Visit any of Fidelity's locations or visit a website at fidelitygroup.com.
Imagine driving your dream car, doing all the things you never thought you could, like perfecting your parallel parking skills or picking up your date. Everyone loves to dream. Stop dreaming. Start driving with a brand new offer from Scotiabank. With an auto loan from Scotiabank, benefit from no payments for up to 2 months, a low interest rate up to 9 years to repay, and free insurance for the first year up to 2.5% of the loan amount. Promotion ends June 30th, 2022. Stop dreaming and start driving today with an auto loan from Scotiabank.
I'm not afraid to take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm, let me know that you're not a feeling like you make it down the same road.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I'm so glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Wednesday afternoon. If you want to give us a call at all, the numbers to do so are as follow. You can call us on 323-6232 or 325-4316. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. We have been talking about Somerton's resignation. Loretta Butler called Turner, speaking expressly about the leaders not calling, the leader of the Free National Movement, Michael Pintard, not calling for his resignation. And we were speaking to that. And then the points of view that some have around the issue of what a charged member of parliament's circumstance means for the perception of the House of Assembly. I could recount far too many things about stuff that has happened to members of parliament in the House of Assembly that have been scandalous for them. And the extent to which those things could have impacted, and if it was so, the perception of the honorableness of the House of Assembly, countless things. I mean, we lived through periods of such things. And honor matters. Honor is high regard, esteem, etc. That's what honor means. It's a high regard for and esteem. And let's be clear. Many, many people in this country, I cannot say most, I don't know, but many, many people in this country don't today hold politicians in high esteem at all. None, you know. They don't hold them in high esteem. They don't regard them as ethical. They don't regard them as moral. They don't regard them as respectable. They think they're all corrupt. They think they're all thieving their money. They think they're all slunks. That notwithstanding, you want to know what the measure of people's commitment to their parliament is? How many register to vote? How many go out and vote? From time immemorial, saving and except for this last pandemic environment election, 90% of Bahamians and 80 plus percent went out to vote. It is a measure of how seriously and motivated they take their civic responsibility to populate the parliament. Notwithstanding all the scandals, notwithstanding all the this and the that and the next thing, that's what they do. They have done over the years. In the height of the commission, what did we call that commission in the 80s? You know, the one that was looking into political participation in drug trafficking in, throughout the Bahamas and so forth. We had commissions on BTC, we had commissions on, you know, we were in the height of those things. The elections that followed, people went out to the polls. The Commission of Inquiry, that's right. The Commission of Inquiry, that's right. People went out to the polls. 80 plus percent, 90 some percent having registered. Do not compartmentalize, or people can compartmentalize issues. So they can know, okay, but so-and-so got charged, or so-and-so did this. That does not mean all the thing is this. They can do that. And they are shown a capacity to do that over decades in the Bahamas, not over a year, decades in this country. Because they can put into perspective what a thing means. They can put into perspective this one doing something wasn't connected to this one, connected to that one, connected to all of them. Therefore, the whole thing ain't this. And they could do that because, yeah, here's the scenario. Under a FNM administration, three former PLP parliamentarians were brought up on charges. The two cases that went to court under an FNM administration, the people were acquitted. Under the Pindling administration, the Pindling administration set up the Commission of Inquiry. The Pindling administration set up a Commission of Inquiry on itself. Okay? So people are able to see the institution can't be failing if you have these things happening. In this current circumstance, here's a PLP administration that is presiding over a prosecution put by a parliament. But in the circumstances, no one is able to say the prime minister or his colleagues are driving that. Even if people are saying it was a witch hunt and this kind of stuff. So people are able to put these things in perspective so as not to think that they erode the fundamental tenets of the democracy. Now, Adrian Gibson will have choices to make. Now, let me tell you the two circumstances under which I see an Adrian Gibson deciding to resign. Deciding, had nothing to do with being forced to resign. This has nothing to do with any legal requirement for him to do so. So we put that out of the way. We don't put that to bed. It won't be because Adrian Gibson thinks, geez, you know, this is bringing the House of Assembly into disrespect, disrepute, ill esteem. It won't be because of that. Because if that's a fundamental issue in the government of the Bahamas, then he could list resignations from thy kingdom come to now. That wouldn't be the reason. That surely wouldn't be the reason. He has a decision to make based on this, you know, on the most fundamental democratic level. I have been hearing from far too many constituents, and they are telling me this is bothering them to no end, and they do not like what it means for their representation. That's the first and most powerful reason. And he says, therefore, in honor of their vote and their trust and charge to me, I am exiting this seat with all the implications that means. That's the first and most fundamental democratic thing. That's it. That's it right there. That's it. That's the thing that matters to me. That's the thing that keeps intact the honor and integrity of the democratic system, because the vote is sacrosanct. The vote. A senator in the United States of America has a higher rank than a congressman. A senator is voted in by the people in America. A senator in the Bahamas has a higher rank than a member of parliament in the Bahamas. But they're not voted in by the people. And that's why the Constitution don't permit them to do certain things like move a money bill in a chamber where the people's vote didn't put the people there because of the people's money being spent. So your Constitution recognizes the sanctity of the vote, even if it symbolically gives a higher ranking to a chamber, calling it the upper chamber. So if that's the surveying that he's doing and the surveying that the party's doing, and they get the sense that there is a consensus that this can't fly, he does the honorable thing and resigns. That's the first and most fundamental. The only other way I see it happening is he says himself. He says himself to himself. What I am up against is incontrovertible and insurmountable. And if there's any possibility that I should be able to at least give the greatest effort in defending myself and the time required to do that, I need to have my attention fully focused in that direction. And for that reason, I'm out of here. There is perhaps one other reason. That his family says to him that in all our interest, you need to step down, dedicate yourself to this cause, do what you can. But outside of that, I simply, honestly, I just don't see the calls for his resignation panning out. I do not. But I do note that perhaps in that time, in that period when there's more full of something, and we have evidence that people might say, okay, well, you know, in the face of that, maybe you need to just step aside. Let's be sure. A Michael Pintard calling for Aidan Gibson's resignation would be as powerless as me calling for it, because it compels him to do nothing. It compels him to do nothing. All it would do is you say, oh, well, it gives him a good look. Really? Gives him a good look. Mm-hmm. Gives him a good look. Mm-hmm. Because he's in the business of himself having a good look and having his party have a bad look. All those things have to be taken into consideration. Adrian Gibson, let me tell you something. I saw in the United States of America, I saw senators, congressmen, do some things and say some things that any sane individual would say, my God, how could a party stand behind them? How could a party in good conscience stand behind them? You know why they stood behind them? Because they was reading the revenue line. What's the revenue line? The votes. Because as bad as you think that person was, they influence votes. And the vote is what keeps. It's reality. As bad as you think they are, there are people who support them. And you think Adrian Gibson don't have no support? Did he win the last seat when his party lost? And if you run a by-election, which is likely now to be even tighter than it was before, and people decide that they ticked off with you because of the way you treat him, that's not going to now matter in the scheme of things? Okay. That you abandon him in his hour of need when you could have done it a different way so as not to throw him under the bus, when you could have kept his support while at the same time saying, listen, bro, under the circumstances X, Y, and Z. Hmm? Wisdom is why you require wisdom, because life is complicated. Life is complex. And sometimes you have to consider so many different perspectives where astuteness is really manifest. Not in simplistic thinking or simplicity of perspectives, but in the complexity of the circumstances. And by no means is this circumstance a simple one. If someone calls for Adrian Gibson's resignation to what I believe they are altogether wrong, no, not at all. I could understand why someone could arrive at that conclusion, but I could also, in examining the thing in other ways, see why someone might say that's not wise, particularly in the moment. Loretta Butler Turner said Adrian Gibson is the party's colleague, friend, family. How do you treat a friend, a colleague, and family in their difficult circumstances? Do you throw them under the bus? Do you say, oh, all the society's better off if you take this stand against them so that we could? Or do you say quietly to them, bro, we'll support you where we can. Given what we know, that it may be prudent for you to bow out and allow for us to at least have a chance at what might be a replacement for yourself. With grace and dignity and support, you give and do that for somebody. That's a family member. That's a friend. That's an associate. That's a colleague. That is most especially a leader. We have some text here. So I see no reason, absolutely no reason, for Mr. Gibson to resign. I'm not reading the rest of that because I know. We got a call on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Hey, good afternoon, Zhivargo.
Hi, how you doing, sir?
Doing great, man. Like yourself?
Good, good. Not bad. Thank you, right here.
Good, good. I'd like to thank you so much for your clear articulation. Even though you said they are your opinions, these opinions are also shared by many fair-minded, balanced Bahamians out here who's looking at the sensitivity of this case. Even though it's not, it is supposedly on its way to the courts. But sadly, you know, if you were to go by what is being said here in the public domain, this man, who is, according to law, innocent until proven guilty, is already guilty on all counts. And that is the part that troubles me so much. If this was in the United States, and you could correct me, Zhivargo, with the way this case is being discussed out here in the public domain, how in the world can this man have a fair trial if he's going to be judged? Well, let me ask you, is he going to be judged by his peers?
I think somebody could help me, but I think it's a jury case. I don't think it's a judge. I don't think just, I think so, but I don't know. I'm not sure. But it is a fair question. If there's a jury going to listen to it, it is a fair question.
Exactly, because these persons out here aren't sequestered. They're not being blocked away from all of this talk in the public domain and everything. And we actually have persons out here acting as judge, jury, and executioner with this young man. You see, what bothers me so much, Zhivargo, it could be me or it could be you. And I put myself in this young man's shoes. And I could imagine, you know, charges, anyone could put it. The burden here is that, you know, the charges have got to be proven, but you have already proven me guilty before the charges are even answered to. And that is the difficulty that a lot of us out here are having. And I'll close on this one point, Zhivargo. You see, a lot of persons out here playing party politics. Oh, if you speak up for Adrian Gibson or speak out for his rights, oh, you are not a PLP or you don't support the PLP. And I'm talking with a lot of them right now who are looking at this, and I always tell them, put yourself in the young man's shoes if these charges may be trumped up or people are just saying these things about you and they're not true. You gotta give this opportunity a chance to be fleshed out. Saying that he's going to be in the courts, let the courts decide his innocence or guilt officially. Instead of us out here already being judged during execution against your man, you know, and that's my main concern. But Zhivargo, continue to articulate the points as you are, because I can tell you, I learned one or two things from you just listening to you today, and I am very much 1,000% with your views on this matter going forward. Thanks for taking my call, man.
Thank you. I appreciate you calling. You know, the more subtle challenge in the circumstances, this, there are folks who are saying, yes, he's innocent until proven guilty. But they're then discounting that against the wider implications of his presence in the House of Assembly for the regard of that place. Okay? And so I understand someone coming from that direction. You can't discount the notion of innocent until proven guilty. You can't discount it. You especially can't discount it in light of the fact that if you are charged in a court convicted and sentenced to jail for less than 12 months, you do not immediately get disqualified to be a member of parliament. You're in jail for 11 months and still the people's representative and not disqualified, saving except you resign. And the Constitution made that provision. And don't you can't tell me it's only a legal something, because in the broad scheme of things, the only way to get an House of Assembly is by law. You don't get an House of Assembly by morals and ethics. You get there by law. And the framers of the Constitution, sitting down thinking through the robustness of the democracy, decided that this should be so. You know why? Because they know it is possible to go to jail for something which, yes, they prove on you in the court of law, but, right? They decided that. But that person, by the Constitution, could stay, but having been charged, because of the look of it, I should go. I should volunteer to go. In other words, I should volunteer to do what my opponents could not do through an election. I should volunteer to do because I'm charged, not convicted, but charged. And that is sound. That you went and made your case to the people, could not get me unelected. Now I'm charged, and I should now do the favor of resigning. Why? Because it ain't gonna be a good look for all of us. Really? When we could count a million things that may not be a good look for the House Assembly based on behavior and all that kind of stuff. No, if a man decides to make that decision, I ain't gonna be against him. If he decides not to make that decision, I ain't gonna be against him. Unless, see, if he decides not to make that decision, even though that's not his personal interest, well, that on his end. If he decide not to make that decision against the will of his voters, then I will have something to say about that. Not before, and not until. Text says, Mr. Laing, Adrian Gibson is charged. Does not mean he's guilty. He was voted in by the people, and he has a right to serve the people who have elected him. Just say that a by-election happens, and Adrian resigns and then runs as an independent and wins. Just remember, not everyone that is charged ends up guilty. That's interesting. That's interesting. That'd be very interesting. If he resigns, runs as an independent, wins. That'd be really interesting. That'd be something. Well, I might pay to see that movie. Go ahead, Carlo. We're listening to you.
Hey, good afternoon. Chivago, how are you doing today?
Hey, I'm right here, man. How are you?
I'm doing okay, through the grace of God. Thank you for asking. Can you hear me clearly, Chivago?
Yeah, very clearly. Very clearly, my
excellent
friend.
Excellent. I'm just smiling, you know. Boy, you know. You and I
don't have many occasions to be on the same page, but I was listening to you today. I was listening to you today, and we are on the same page in some respects.
yes. you know, the funny thing with it, Chivago, piggybacking off of all of what you have said thus far, because I've been listening to you from the start, right? And I support what you have expressed wholeheartedly, to be frank. And also, piggybacking off of what Jeff said, right? When he called your show a moment ago, where he expressed, you know, it could be you today or it could be me tomorrow, right? And we would want for equality. We would want for fairness. We would want for the weight to take place in the balancing of the scale before any decision, whether it be public or whether it be to the judiciary, is rendered, right? And you know, that took me back, Zhivargo. I tell you, no lie. I listened to Sheen Gibson as well, the Honorable Sheen Gibson, former cabinet minister, on one show. You know, and I don't talk about it much, but that also took me back, Zhivargo. Just as this instance
has taken me back because I was one who was in that shoe. You understand what I'm saying, Zhivargo? I was one who was in that shoe and had to go through the entire Supreme Court system in order to clear my name, right? To vindicate my name, my family's name, right? And I understand what it is to be out there and, you know, you're wandering around and you're looking to see who's decent, who's fair-minded, who's just in their thought, in their execution, who will give you support, what actually convict you, right? Who will take on your matter and defend it with everything that they have in it, believing in you as strongly as the evidence that the other side is presenting against you, right? And challenge them in court. And so, man, Zhivargo, and this is why I cannot follow. I'm not a follower, okay? I cannot follow the loud noise or the crowd. I never was, and I never will be. And taking that position, Zhivargo, as you have expressed on many instances, in particular when you first took over the show Z Live on Guardian, where you expressed some of the challenges that you had to overcome, where you were, people were looking for you to do some things that you did not want to do, and there are some consequences that comes with such decisions. But I was never a follower, and I cannot be a follower, and I will not stand by. I'm not speaking to Mr. Gibson's innocence nor guilt. I'm speaking to process. I'm speaking to due process. I'm speaking to democracy. I'm speaking to weighing in the balance the actual voters who matter the most in the sacrosanct situation. And I'm speaking to, pardon me?
No, I was just going to say I got to take a break, but I just wanted you to wrap up for me.
Okay, I'm going to wrap up right now. And I just want to say this is not political for me. And so all evil-minded individuals who are of the political mindset and try to brand me as a whatever, That's your business. But I'll stay on the straight and narrow. Thank you, Zhivargo.
I appreciate you calling. Thank you, man. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a break. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand.
That's right, boys and girls, get ready to play basketball at the 34th annual Jeff Rogers Basketball Camp, July 4th through July 29th at the Kendall GL Isaacs Gym, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. daily. So parents, get your boys and girls ages 5 through 18 registered now. Applications available at the South Bahamas Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, Tonic Williams Darling Highway, and at the registration desk at Campsite Kendall GL Isaacs Gym. Special appearances by NBA players, legends, and coaches. So get your boys and girls registered now, ages 5 through 18, for the 34th annual Jeff Rogers Basketball Camp, July 4th through July 29th.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Look at today. Workout, breakfast, drop kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
Imagine driving your dream car, doing all the things you never thought you could, like perfecting your parallel parking skills or picking up your date. Everyone loves to dream. Stop dreaming. Start driving with a brand new offer from Scotiabank. With an auto loan from Scotiabank, benefit from no payments for up to 2 months, a low interest rate up to 9 years to repay, and free insurance for the first year up to 2.5% of the loan amount. Promotion ends June 30th, 2022. Stop dreaming and start driving today with an auto loan from Scotiabank.
I'm not afraid to take a stand. Everybody, take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm. Send you know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Wednesday afternoon. If you want to give us a call, the numbers to do so are as follow. You can call us on 323-6232 or 325-4316. You can text us on 422-4796 or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. We have some text here. Let me read for you. Oh, where did all these come from all of a sudden? Ooh. This text says, good afternoon, Mr. Laing. Did your guest say Rhodey? I heard Guyana, not Trinidad, but still, is the information about the fair on the BFM website working so only partially listening? Oh, so sorry. I don't know. You can check the site, though. You never know. This text says, Zhivargo, we all know what the PLP wants, a by-election. While I don't support Aidan Gibson, I say let's wait until then, next general election, to deal with Aidan Gibson if the justice system does not deal with him first, because our country does not need another election campaign right now. That's interesting. This text says, I see Anton calling in to warn in full support of Aidan Gibson. The last man I saw Anton giving full support to was an embattled Hubert Minnis in 2021. It was clear then, as it is now, why he supports those men. They both damaged the FNM as a political concern and helped the PRP's cause. Boy, y'all are some conspiracists now. Antoine, he got you on the conspiracy list. This text says, Mr. Laing, listening in from Orlando, I have been told that he should not resign. The decision is in the hands of the people of Long Island until such time that Mr. Gibson is convicted of a crime or the people of Long Island ask for his resignation. All opinions. It says those were extremely sloppy cases brought under the Minnis administration, and the atmosphere under the Pinling administration was very, very different from today. Pinling was the ultimate strong man. So what does that matter? I mean, I don't understand what the point is. This text says if the charges were made from a regular citizen, then you might insinuate that, but the police department brought not one, but 56 fraud charges. As a public figure, I am MP. He needs to do the honorable thing and step down for now. We need to stop justifying everything, confusing the youth, muddying the waters wrong. Listen to me. I'm going to say this strongly because that statement right there is stupid. It's stupid. Let me tell you why it's stupid. Because it is defying the very justice system. Do you believe that the police has never brought before the courts anyone that has been found innocent or acquitted? Yes, the same police department brought the case, brought all the charges for murder, rape, and whatever. People got off. So don't tell people things like that, man. Don't tell people things like that. That is not wise, right? It is possible that the police could err. That is possible. I'm not saying they did, but it is possible. That's why you have a trial. That's the whole nature of the trial. I mean, how silly is it to say, because you charge it, there has to be something there, and therefore somebody should resign, and that's muddying the water and confusing you. You are a confused youth or a confused adult to say something so silly. That's the nature of a trial. That's why we have this. We didn't invent a notion, innocent until proven guilty. That's it. That's our system. That's why the man is out on bail. That's why he's not locked up and found guilty already. He has to go through a trial. All right? Don't let anybody hear you say that, man. That's not sensible. That's not sensible at all. This text says, Professor Laing, you're right in my view. I believe while the circumstances surrounding the MP for Long Island, plus a loyal subject of the Constitution, I believe the MP has a right to fair trial, and if proven guilty, then he should resign. Also, senators and cabinet are honorable outside. Yes, senators too. I was talking expressly about cabinets. So you're right. Senators are. And senators and cabinet ministers are the only two representatives who are honorable outside of parliament. MPs are only honorable inside the parliament. That's right. Good day, Mr. Laing. I agree with you entirely regarding the calling of the resignation of Mr. Gibson. This text says a man is considered innocent until proven guilty, and if there is not, must. And if not, must he resign? See, I say, hold on there, brother. Okay. Tech says, good day, Mr. Laing. This is an interesting discussion this afternoon. Thanks. I personally believe that Mr. Gibson ought not to remain as an MP whilst corruption charges are pending against him. It is not a good look. Imagine him asking him to be excused from attending the House of Assembly because he is across the road sitting in the prisoner's dock. Have a good day. boy, good luck. Okay. Good luck with that. Good luck. All right, we are we have a call on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Well, good afternoon, Zhivargo.
Hi, how you doing, man?
I'm always doing great.
Good.
You know, I live in the third richest economy in the hemisphere, so why wouldn't I be doing great? And it never snows. You know, interesting what's going on. I'm not sure which side I'm on, but it is providing a great distraction from some of the more serious issues. But since we're going to go down this rabbit trail, I call it, let's look at Boris Johnson running around doing whatever he was doing when people couldn't leave their house. You remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Remember the party?
Mm-hmm.
I want to know if any of that went on around here, because, you know, how would we ever know? We should play back the surveillance camera and see what's on the street. But anyway.
But if you were paying attention, one of those things did happen, right? Did not the prime minister say that he was he went on Christmas time to go shopping, contrary to COVID rules? And you know, that was a big controversy. Remember?
Yeah, but we didn't do anything about it. Looked like in England.
No. But I'm saying you're saying if you wonder if anything like that went around. I'm just saying that was one of the incidences that was discussed.
You're correct. I don't want to fixate on it. You're correct. But Boris ain't going nowhere, even though most of his people, they ain't on his side. You see what's happening with him. So I guess we're mimicking the Westminster system to a, to the T. Now, I hope we don't allow at some point in this honorable country ankle bracelets in the House of Assembly. And that's sarcasm. You know, seriously, Zhivargo, we need to really look at the... We need to look at the economy one day, because 7 million tourists fed 400,000 Bahamians. Now we have how many of those Bahamians won't eat? But this is
distraction. Hold on. You say it's a distraction. You say it's a distraction, right? Did we talk about this yesterday?
Did we talk? No. See.
Did we talk about this the day before yesterday?
Not you, but many others.
No. Even on the other shows, they were discussing many different things. See, one of the things that happens sometimes, you might do it, but other people do it, is just because you're talking about something today doesn't mean that's the only thing you've ever been talking about, right?
Well, of course.
It's just it's a topic today.
Mm-hmm. But
today.
You know, it is what it is. Let's get back to the subject. I think... The Bible says abstain from the appearance of evil, does it not? So,
yeah.
So we are a Christian country, I think, up until midnight. So I think that we should do what the Bible says. But it doesn't really matter because,
who's the we who should do it? Because the only person in this instance who has anything to do is Adrian Gibson. So who's the we? What do you want him to do?
Well, I would hope he's a Christian like most of us and would abstain from the appearance of evil.
I see. And you think that's what that means? You think that's what that means? That if somebody accuses you of something, that it means then that you should just go and fade off into the sunset? That's what you think that means? That's not what that means.
I didn't say fade into the sunset now.
No, that's not what that means. So did you read the context in which that was said? Right? It was in the context of people who are idol worshippers, who are sitting down to have a meal while they are idol worshipping, and you're participating with them in that. So as not to appear to be participants in that evil, you don't do that. So this is different than somebody sitting down with a group of, let's say drug dealers, while they are drug dealing. The Bible is saying, don't you do that. Because remember, Jesus was called a wine bibber and a sinner because he hung out with wine bibbers and sinners. And they called him that. And he said, no, I'm doing this because the sick have need of a physician, not the healthy. So don't state these things out of context.
But I gotta run now, Zhivargo, to another appointment.
I understand,
but I can leave you with this one, Zhivargo.
Okay.
I think you said if he runs independent, if he's cleared of charges and whatever, and he runs independent, he would be a great spoiler. And I think if we had, you know, yellow, red, independent, and maybe one of the, I don't know if the DNA's still there or the COI, you know, I'd throw my hand in that ring, you know, because I think Long Island needs an airport, of course, but they need a city.
Well, you should. I think you'd make an interesting candidate.
I tell you one thing. I would take, now tell me if this is doable, because you've been an MP. Can I take out a full page ad in the newspaper and say, if I cannot start this airport and city, because you need a city, nobody moves to an airport. They move to a city. Mm. If I can't start both of these things within the first year, I will tender my resignation and sign this before I run, and you can remove me because you have a legal binding document. Now, you've never seen an MP do that before, eh?
No, you could do that, though.
And as Long Island would say, no, man, never seen nothing like that, Bella. But I tell you, Zhivargo, I could throw my hat in the ring if that one come up, you know, as independent.
I got you, brother. Thanks a lot for calling. We appreciate it. Producer, let's pay our respects to our sponsors and give them this final break, please. Ladies and gentlemen, listening to see live, I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
Take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm. Whatever weather, cold or warm, let me know that you're not alone. Holler if you feel like you've been down the same road.
Around the world, Cleveland Clinic is recognized as a leader in healthcare. Our team of experts relentlessly pursues the best for our patients. From groundbreaking cancer research to state-of-the-art heart surgery, life-saving innovations happen here every day. When it's time to travel for your health, it's time to travel to Cleveland Clinic, your destination for care. For every care in the world. To learn more, visit clevelandclinic.org/Caribbean.
Switch for better when you move your mortgage to Scotiabank.
Leave behind that old mortgage plan and open the door to a low interest rate. No payments for up to 2 months and cash back of 2.5% of the mortgage amount up to $10,000. And guess what? It gets better. Apply for your Scotiabank credit card and enjoy a low 9.99% introductory rate for the first 6 months. Switch for better and upgrade your mortgage today with Scotiabank. Offer ends June 30th, 2022.
The Water and Sewage Corporation advises residents of Pinecrest Drive, South Beach East, that the corporation will commence improvement work on Tuesday, May 31st, 2022, for a duration of 5 weeks, from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. daily. During this period, there may be some interruption in the water supply, road closure, and detours around the work area. Motorists are advised to avoid the area where possible. The corporation apologizes for any inconvenience caused and appreciates your support as they work to improve their level of service.
Have you taken a look at those investment options yet?
Too busy. Raw kids at school, back-to-back meetings, dog from the groomer, nails, and that's all before 12. How come you're so chill?
That's because my money is as busy as you.
At RF, we find the best Bahamian and international investments to keep your money busy so you can spend more time focusing on you. Contact us at rfgroup.com to find out more. RF, money at work.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. We have a few texts I want to read for you before we wind up the show. This text is, every time one of our MPs mess up the noise in the markets, they resign. And in most cases, they do. When the PLP messes up, they remain in office. I say innocent until proven guilty. Resign does not help us win. Resigning does not help us win elections, says the text. This text says, how many by-elections were won by a party in opposition? Not many, I would bet. Ain't many at all. Right? No, many at all. Says, good day, Zhivargo, an excellent show as usual, and thank you for having sound and balanced views. I believe Mr. Adrian Gibson is innocent until proven guilty, and we should allow the courts to decide and then let the parliamentary rules apply. Personally, I believe, should Mr. Gibson resign prematurely, he may perhaps sabotage his effort in winning his case because he will lose his income and perhaps not be able to pay his lawyers to assist him in winning his case. Finally, Mr. Gibson must apply wisdom in this matter and not get distracted by naysayers. Thank you for your comment. Okay, we got some more text here. Let me see if I can get them in. Text is Mr. Laing. Mr. Gibson finds himself in a very unfortunate situation. However, his inner conscience should dictate to him what to do. Resigning would not solve the issue. Let the Constitution and the law run its course. This text says he's also a public figure caught up in allegations. That's not stupid. It's an opinion. This text says, I think this matter is one of Mr. Gibson's personal conviction and his constituents. Bahamians love to play politics with people's lives. This text says, hi, Mr. Laing. I appreciate your show on how it's very informative and educating me on how our Constitution works as a citizen in our country. Continue the good work. Thank you. Says Antoine gave hundreds of thousands in contracts to his... I don't have time for nonsense, people. Right? Don't text me about nonsense. It ain't something you could substantiate on. Unless go down the stupid one. Anyways, I do think it is a weighty matter to discuss. I do believe it's worth discussing. We can't discuss the case itself. Nobody can talk about whether somebody's innocent or guilty or anything of that nature. But I do think that the merits of resigning, not resigning as an issue, because this is a first for us. And well, it's a first for us in a long time. For a generation, this is a first for us. Resigning in the circumstances, it's a worthy public policy discussion. It's probably going to continue to be a point of discussion. And we, of course, who are in the media, we will have to be careful about not offending the matter sub judice. But I imagine people will continue to toss out this issue. And then when the next time something like this happens, God forbid, then we say, we have some precedents. And we know what thoughts are surrounding it. And we go from there. I only repeat what I have said before. The vote is sacrosanct. The vote. Frustrating the vote is frustrating the democracy. As the vote makes possible the representation, it is the vote that should weigh heaviest in determination of that representation. It is the vote that matters the most. The vote, your vote, my vote, our vote. That is where the power of a democracy resides. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I trust you have a great evening. God bless. We'll talk to you again tomorrow. I'm not afraid.